That's good banjo. Thanks, Ben. So we've got some more questions to answer here from our moderator page.
Ah, next question.
Next question. I've got it right here on my G-pad. The question comes again from Mark Art in Barcelona, Spain. Asks, he has a lot of questions, but his questions have been rated very highly here too. What can I do to get an interview at Google?
Send $20. No, kidding.
That's sort of a tricky question because it's sort of like, you know, where do you start here? Okay, there's a number of different ways you can do it. Mm-hmm. One way is you can do something incredible, right? Here's an example. Yesterday was the 5-year anniversary of the mashup that Paul Rademacher made,
right?
With the mm-hmm. Craigslist housing stuff. Mm-hmm. And you know, that was pretty incredible. Paul Rademacher now works at Google, right? So that's one way of getting an interview, is doing something really interesting and novel and innovative on the web that gets our attention.
It's pretty hard to do, though, for a regular guy on the street to just do something amazing. Well, I mean,
it's one way.
I think what I tell people to do, honestly, especially if you're just coming out of school, is to get involved in an open source project. One of the things I love about open source projects is that it's basically a free internship if you get involved, right? A lot of folks come out of school, they don't have recommendations. Maybe they can get a recommendation from a professor, but they have no real world job recommendations or colleague recommendations. But if they've been working on an open source project, maybe while they're in university, and they've made a real impact there, it is a completely transparent job experience. I can go look up their code. Yeah. I can look at their emails on the project. I can see their actual impact and get a sense of their accomplishments.
But it also shows one of the things that you talked about in the past, which is that it shows that this is somebody who really likes to write software.
There's a passion there. Right?
You know, there's a passion there. If you don't love to write software, you're not going to spend your spare time writing it, right? You're going to do your classwork in school. You're going to go to your 9-to-5 job. You're going to check out, and then you'll go do whatever it is that you really mm-hmm. like to do. So I think working in open source is a great thing. If you're looking at colleges, going to a good school, a top tier school is one way of helping to get attention and getting good grades, and again doing something while you're there. So it's not just sort of one thing; it's a lot of different things that sort of you want to make your resume stand out, not just because you've listed everything under the sun, but because you've actually accomplished something. We really do look at resumes, I think, for people who have done something, right?
Well, I mean, the thing is, we get so many resumes every single day.
Thousands a day,
that
I think,
look exactly the same. It's like everybody has a computer science degree, everybody has 50,000 acronyms listed with technologies that they've played with at some point, but that doesn't distinguish it from one another, right? If we see something like, made this really amazing product in my spare time for fun, right? I worked on this really cool open source project, something like that that's going to make it not just look like a list of acronyms. That's really going to get our attention, and that's what's going to get the recruiter calling you for an initial interview.
And this sort of comes back to the whole resume writing thing, right? Yeah. I mean, when you write your resume, you really want it to focus on things you've done. Don't just list a whole bunch of things, you know, I was member of a team, blah, blah, blah. You know, say that led a team that launched this, that did that, or mm-hmm. focus on your execution there.
On the other hand, do not lie about what you did either.
That would be bad.
Fluffing resumes is a very common thing, and I know a lot of books say to, you know, pad your resume this way and that. Google engineers, if you get into interviews, they will call you on every bit of it. They will ask you about every little bit of thing on your resume, and you will be embarrassed if you list something there that you actually don't know anything about.
Right.
Or that you spent 1 hour thinking about and then walked away.
And be careful too, because if you put on there that you're an expert at PostScript, you might wind up being interviewed by someone who has worked on PostScript in the past. Right. We have people at Google who have written parts of the C language. We have people who contributed to Java. I mean, so it's definitely, I think it's important, it's an opportunity to show what you've done and what you know, mm-hmm. And you know, it's definitely the chance to toot your own horn, but it's definitely not a chance to toot a horn that's not your own.
I agree.
Back to you.